Hello everybody, it's Tom and Jerry Fan 64 here. It's now time to do another collection video, another VHS collection video, which this time I'm going to be showing my Universal VHS collection. But first, there's a Paramount tape I actually missed in my Paramount VHS collection. You guys are probably asking what I missed. And that is a Very Brady sequel. This tape I actually forgot to show in my Paramount VHS collection. I didn't realize it until now. The fourth to Gannett and I 7. Now let's show the Universal tapes. These first four are Universal Family Features tapes. I hope to get the original 1987 VHS of this one. The 31st to get 1998 has a side with here, but it has an ad for An American Tale 3, The Treasure of Manhattan Island, which I actually might get on VHS, maybe. I probably will. Even though I said I wasn't going to get the third and fourth The American Tale movies, but I'm going to get them to complete the collection. Now, I also got An American Tale, Five-O Goes West. I hope to get the McDonald's print of this one. 31st to get 1998 as well, so it has a cyber printer code. This is THX certified. I used to have the 1996 VHS print, the 13th to get 1996. But I got rid of that copy for no reason, but I got this tape back in the collection. The 47th again, 1999. The last Universal Family Features tape I have. The 46th again, 1998. I didn't mean to skip the label, sorry. From here on out, I'm going to show my face on camera for the collection videos, because when I don't show my face on camera, the camera gets blurry. I also got the Land Before Time 5, The Mysterious Island. This tape came sealed when I got it. The 261st day in 1997, which I looked up, the print date is September 18th in 1997, and printed the 45th again in 1997. So yeah, I wrote the print date. As you guys can see, I wrote the print date on here. Again, if you didn't hear the day and year code is the 261st day in 1997. I also got the Land Before Time 7, The Stone of Cold Fire. I only have a select few Land Before Time movies. The 51st to get 2000. Sorry, I didn't mean to skip the label yet again. I also got the Land Before Time 9, Journey to Big Water. There's something rare about this tape. The 45th to get 2002. This has black reels. I checked the closing to this tape. This tape sadly does not have the Macrovision logo at the end. It's pretty weird it doesn't have it. This is the 2002 release of ET. I used to have the 1994 VHS. I think the 1994 reprint, which I'm planning on getting rid of. Black reels. The 39th to get 2002. This one yet again does not have the Macrovision logo at the end. Last clamshell I have. This is a rare tape. The 13th to get 2004. I will check the closing to this tape to see if it has the Macrovision logo at the end. Same thing with the Land Before Time 7, The Stolen Cold Fire. I used to have a copy of this tape printed the 53rd to get 2004, but I got rid of that copy broke, but I got a better copy of Friday Night Lights. Purchased from Blockbuster on July 17th, 2005. So that was 2 days after my fourth birthday. And this has the same Blockbuster date as my VHS of Cellular, which I showed yesterday in my New Line Cinema VHS collection. I will check the closing to see if this has a Macrovision logo at the end. The 51st to get down for. These next two movies are Focus Features movies. I didn't even know this tape even existed until I found this at a garage sale. 36 to get 2004. Yet again, I'm going to check the closing to see if it has the Macrovision logo at the end. Same thing with this one. I will check the closing to see if this has the Macrovision logo at the end. Focus Features Spotlight Series. I heard this was a great movie. Same thing with Eternal Sunshine of the Spotless Mind. There's something rare about this tape. This has a UK-style print date. The 27th of September 2004, which is September 27th, 2004, and the 53rd to get Town 4. This is a Town 5 VHS, however. This is the McDonald's print. This tape came sealed when I got it as well. white screen of death printing, so we all know what it has. The N40th, Ikon at Night 4. I used to have a copy of this tape printed to 44th, Ikon at Night 4, but I got rid of it for no reason. But I'm glad I have this tape back in collection. I do hope to get the 1990 VHS of that one, the original release. This next one's really rare. I never heard of this movie until I got this tape. I got this because it has John Travolta, Heather Graham, and James Walters. This is a Canadian copy. It says VIR on the side. I didn't mean to skip the label, sorry. Printings, but no print date. I had to get this tape because it's a Canadian tape. My only Canadian VHS I have from Universal. I heard this movie got a 0% on Rotten Tomatoes, but I will still keep this tape because it's a Morgan Creek film. Universal and Morgan Creek. Made on a Scotch cassette. White Screen of Death printings. The 36th again, 1990. I used to have the Universal Comedy Greats VHS of this, but I got rid of it for no reason. I do have this movie on DVD. I have the 1998 DVD, but it's a reprint from 2007. The end label fell off, and there's White Screen of Death printings. 43rd again at night, too. I do hope to get the Universal Comedy Greats version of this tape back in the collection. And if you want to see my DVD of Kindergarten Cop, watch my DVD collection in my comparison video on Kindergarten Cop. This is a Gramercy Pictures movie, as you can see right here. This tape's recycled. The 17th again, 1998, and the 43rd again at 95. Lionsgate movie. I do hope to get more tapes that are Universal and Lionsgate tapes. This is a former rental from Hollywood Video. The 25th again at 99. I doubt this will have the Macrovision logo at the end. I'm not going to bother checking. This next one's a widescreen tape. Has a nice shiny cover. The 4th again at 99. I almost said 1997. The 4th again at 99. These next two are demo tapes, but the tape after this is very rare. This tape came sealed when I got it. The 52nd Week of 2000. So this tape is an early print. The 52nd Week of 2000 is the year code. This next tape is really rare. I'm going to count to three on this tape. It is the 1986 demo VHS of Back to the Future. This is a rare one. I found this at a garage sale. I didn't even know a demo tape of this existed. The label unfortunately fell off, and it says MCIAIM. There is no print date or Ikon error code on this tape. I do have to get a copy that has the label intact. Got this because it has John Candy. This movie I used to absolutely hate back in 2014, but I now enjoyed this movie. The 34th Ikon 1998, so this is a reprint. The second to last Universal tape with the case. This is a 1975 movie. This is the follow-up to the movie True Grit. 50th, I think it's 2001. And the last Universal tape I have with the case is Schindler's List. This is a two-tape set. Okay. Here's tape one. And here's tape two. And both tapes are printed on the 18th, again, 1999. Now to the three caseless tapes I have from Universal. I remember the print date was October 5th, 1984. I wrote the print date on the label. I had to tape the label back on. And the print date had a blue sticker print date, but the print date fell off. I hope to get Conan the Barbarian sometime. Unfortunately, my VHS of Conan the Destroyer is colory at the beginning. It's very jumpy. 36th, 1998. And final Universal tape. 37th, 2001. So that is it.